Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have seen the multiplication of the two unsigned binary numbers. So in this video, let us see the multiplication of the signed binary numbers. Now typically in the digital systems, the signed numbers are represented in the 2's complement form. So let us see how to perform the multiplication of the two binary numbers which are represented in the 2's complement form. So let us take one example, and through that, let us understand this multiplication procedure. So let's say we want to multiply the minus 5 and the 7 in the binary form. So first of all, let us represent these two numbers in the 4-bit 2's complement form. So in the earlier videos, we have already seen that how to represent any signed number in the 2's complement form. So for the positive numbers, this 2's complement representation is same as the unsigned binary number representation. So as you know, in the 4-bit, this plus 7 can be represented as this 0111, where this MSB represents the signed bit. But for the negative numbers, this 2's complement representation is different. So here, let us see how to represent this minus 5 in the 2's complement form. So to represent this minus 5 in the 2's complement form, first of all, let us write the plus 5 in the 4-bit form, and that is equal to 0101. And now, to represent the minus 5 in the 2's complement form, just start from the LSB, and as you move towards the MSB of the number, then keep all the bits as it is until you encounter the first one. And then after, replace all the zeros by 1 and the 1s by zeros. So in this number, starting from the LSB, the first number that we encounter is the 1. So this 1 will be kept as it is. And after that, all the zeros will be replaced by 1 and the 1s will be replaced by the 0. So in this way, we can easily find the 2's complement representation for the negative numbers. That means the minus 5 in the 2's complement form is equal to 1011. And the plus 7 can be represented as 0111. So now in general, when we are multiplying the two n-bit numbers, then at the most, the number of bits in the product term will be equal to 2n. For example, if you take the two 4-bit numbers, then the maximum 4-bit number which we can have is equal to 15. And in the binary, that is equal to 1111. That means this 15 cross 15 will be equal to 225. And in the binary, it can be represented like this. So to represent this number, we will require at least 8 bits. That means when we are multiplying the 2 n-bit numbers, then at the most, the number of bits in the product term will be equal to 2n. So now when we are multiplying the negative binary numbers, then additionally, we also need to perform the sign extension. Or in other words, we need to extend the sign bit of the partial products after the each multiplication. So in general, when we are multiplying the 2 n-bit numbers in the 2's complement form, then the sign bit of the each partial product will be extended up to the 2 n-bits. Or in case of the 4-bit numbers, the sign bit of the each partial product will be extended up to the 8 bits. Now as you know, with the sign extension, the value of the number will remain the same. For example, if we represent this 0111 in the 8-bit form, then we need to extend the sign of this MSB up to the 8 bits. And still, the value of the number will remain the same. Similarly, let us take the case of the minus 5. So in the 2's complement form, this minus 5 is equal to 1011. So if we want to represent it in the 8-bit form, then we need to extend the sign of this MSB. So in the 8-bit form, this minus 5 can be represented as this 1111. So here, during the multiplication of these two negative numbers, we will extend the sign bit of the each partial product up to the 8 bits. Or in general, we will extend the sign bit of the each partial product up to the 2n bits. But the remaining procedure for the multiplication will remain the same. So now, let us multiply this minus 5 and the 7. So here, starting from the LSB of the multiplier, the first bit is equal to 1. So once we multiply it with the multiplicand or the first number, then the partial product will be same as the multiplicand. Or in this case, that is equal to 1011. So here, if you see the MSB of the partial product, then that is equal to 1. So here, we will extend the sign of this MSB up to the 8 bits. So after the sign extension, this will be our first partial product. Similarly, if we move to the next bit, then once again that is equal to 1. That means in this case also, the partial product will be same as the multiplicand. That is equal to 1011. But in this case, it will get left shifted by a 1 bit position. So once again, here the sign bit of the partial product is equal to 1. So once again, we will extend the sign of this MSB up to the 8 bits. Then after, if we move to the next bit, then once again that is equal to 1. Therefore, once again, the partial product will be same as the multiplicand. Or in this case, that is equal to 1011. But once again, it will get left shifted by a 1 bit position. So once again, we will perform the sign extension and we will extend the sign bit for the next 2 bits. And finally, if you see the MSB, then that is equal to 0. Therefore, the partial product will be equal to 0. And therefore, over here, it is not included in the addition. So now, we need to add all these partial products. And after the addition, we will get this result. So here, in this result, we just need to consider only first 8 bits. That means here, we can neglect these 2 bits. So after ignoring these 2 bits, if we see the sign bit, then that is equal to 1. And in the 2's complement form, this number is equal to minus 35. So in the 2's complement representation, for this 8 bit number, the weight of the MSB will be equal to 2 to the power 7. But here, since the MSB represents the sign bit, so its sign will be equal to negative. While for the remaining bits, the weight will be equal to positive. So if we add the weights of all the bits, then we will get the minus 35. Or in another way also, we can verify this result. So for that, first let us take the 2's complement of the result. So we know that when we take the 2's complement of the negative number, then we will get the corresponding positive number. Or in this case, we should get plus 35. So if we take the 2's complement of the given number, then we will get this number. And if we see the corresponding decimal equivalent, then that is equal to plus 35. So indeed, we can say that our result is equal to minus 35. So in this way, using the sign extension, we can multiply the negative binary numbers. Now in this multiplication, if you observe, then the multiplicand was negative, while the multiplier was positive. But suppose, if the multiplier is also negative, then using this method, we won't get the correct result. And for that, just in the last partial product, we need to do the little modification. So for that, let us take one more example, and through that let us understand it. So let's say, we want to multiply minus 5 and the minus 7. So first of all, let us represent these two numbers in the 4-bit 2's complement form. So we know that in the 4-bit representation, this plus 5 is equal to 0101. Therefore, this minus 5 in the 2's complement form will be equal to 1011. So like I said earlier, starting from the LSB, until we encounter the first one, we will keep all the bits as it is. And after that, we will replace the zeros by 1 and the 1s by zeros. So this is the 2's complement representation for the minus 5. Likewise, this plus 7 in the 4-bit form is equal to 0111. Therefore, this minus 7 in the 2's complement form is equal to 1001. So in this way, we got the 2's complement representation for these two negative numbers. So in the multiplication, starting from the LSB of the multiplier, we will multiply the each bit of the multiplier to the multiplicand. So here, the LSB of the multiplier is equal to 1. Therefore, our first partial product will be same as the multiplicand. That is equal to 1011. So here, in the first partial product, this MSB is equal to 1. So this sign bit will be extended up to the 8 bits. Likewise, the second digit is equal to 0. Therefore, the partial product will be also equal to 0. Similarly, if we move to the next bit, then once again that is equal to 0. Therefore, the partial product will be also equal to 0. And finally, if we see the MSB, then that is equal to 1. That means in this case, the partial product will be same as the multiplicand. But here, this partial product will be left shifted according to its weight. So once again, here the sign bit is extended up to the 8 bits. Now here, when the multiplier is negative, then its sign bit or the MSB will be equal to 1. So during the multiplication, if the MSB of this multiplier is 1, then instead of adding the last partial product, we need to subtract it. And as you know, this subtraction is equivalent of taking the 2's complement of the last partial product. That means whenever the MSB of the multiplier is 1, then we will take the 2's complement of the last partial product. So now, we just need to add all these partial products. So if we perform the addition of all these partial products, then this will be the final result. And here once again, we need to consider only the first 8 bits. So if you see the decimal equivalent of the result, then that is equal to plus 35. And that is our expected result. So in this way, when the multiplier is negative, then in the last partial product, we need to take the 2's complement of that partial product. And then after, we need to add all these partial products. So for better understanding, let us take one more example. So in this example, we will multiply the 5 and the minus 7. So now in this multiplication, if we start from the LSB of the multiplier, then the first bit is equal to 1. Therefore, our first partial product will be same as the multiplicand. That is equal to 0101. And as you can see over here, the sign of the MSB is extended up to the 8 bits. Similarly, if you see the next 2 bits, then that is equal to 0. Therefore, the next 2 partial products will be equal to 0. And finally, if you see the MSB, then that is equal to 1. Therefore, the partial product will be same as the multiplicand. But here, since the MSB is equal to 1, so we will take the 2's complement of the final partial product. So before taking this 2's complement, if we see the last partial product, then that is equal to 0101. And here, the sign of the MSB will be extended up to the 8 bits. But now, if we take the 2's complement, then we will get this number. So now, we just need to add all these partial products. So after the addition, this will be the final result. So here as you can see, since the MSB of the result is equal to 1, it means that the result is negative. And here, this number represents the minus 35. But to verify that, once again, let us take the 2's complement of the result. So if we take the 2's complement of the result, then we will get this number. And its decimal equivalent is equal to plus 35. So we can say that our result is equal to minus 35. Because as you know, when we take the 2's complement of the negative number, then we will get the equivalent positive number. So here, this number corresponds to minus 35. So in this way, we can also perform the multiplication of the 2 signed numbers which are represented in the 2's complement form. So in the upcoming videos, we will see that how the digital circuit performs this multiplication. So basically, we will see the design of the multiplier circuit. But I hope in this video, you understood how to perform the multiplication of the 2 signed binary numbers. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.